at this stage of the game, you have made a number of films which have expanded people's ideas about life and individualism and society and the structure. Do you still have to struggle for money every time you make a film?
Oh, yes. Yeah, not necessarily. I mean, I think I'm in a position where I think they'll take my calls, unless I've had a giant flop. I mean, they'll sometimes interrupt a meeting, not too often. I think I can probably get a meeting, you know. Usually can get slipped in somewhere. I'm very cynical about it, as you can see. but I don't think I can get... I don't think I can readily get finance for the kind of films I want to make, no. I mean, I've got development deals. I've probably got more than I know what to do with at the moment, because I'm so... It takes so long to know whether I'm that involved before I know whether they're involved. In other words, I've got to work on the script for a bit and see if it's working, because there are a number of things that I've abandoned without any regrets. And there are only a few films that I just haven't succeeded in getting off the ground, which I do regret. But it's always a struggle, finally. You've always got to, unless they are desperate to make a certain kind of film. But I mustn't be anti-they. It's too easy to knock them. The cinema's changed appallingly, really, because it's, you know, companies are now owned by huge business conglomerates. So these committees of people that are deciding whether a project should go or not are answerable, and their own careers are at stake. They're answerable to much bigger corporations, and it's no longer individual decision and taste. And people find it much easier to say no than yes, no matter who you are. What does madden me is that entire bodies of work get destroyed by one disastrous flop, and you hear people glibly sitting around dinner tables saying, oh, Stanley Kubrick, yes, well, who I happen to think is one of the great filmmakers, you know, and The Shining comes out, and it isn't as good as his others or as successful, and people are starting to dismiss an entire body of work. Well, that's appalling.
That's like something Billy Wilder said once. He said, I made Lost Weekend, I made Fortune Cookie, I made Some Like It Hot. I didn't suddenly get stupid. And of course, the same thing.
One has a flop. We're all going to have flops.
If you're doing original work, you're going to have one.
You're going to have a flop. And I mean, it's not comfortable, and we all want to be loved. And I like stirring it up every now and again. And I think Falcon the Snowman is healthily controversial, which pleases me. I think it's on one level a jolly good story. On another level, there are a lot of ramifications which people can talk about after seeing the film. And I'm sick and tired of just entertainment, you know, which is you go out and you go in, have a good time and leave. That's all right, but I don't want to spend 2 years of my life doing it.